Picture an engineer. Is this what you pictured? Or this? According to the 2014 Department of Labor survey, although women make up 47% of the total U.S. workforce, they're much less represented in particular science, engineering, and math occupations. 18% of software engineers are women. 12.1% of civil engineers are women. 8.3% of electrical and electronics engineers are women. Research indicates that gender bias is the main factor pushing women out of these fields, not personal choice or pipeline issues. For instance, a 2014 study found that both men and women were twice as likely to hire a man for a job that required math. In a 2012 study, male and female faculty rated male applicants as significantly more competent and hireable than the female applicants with identical application materials. The truth is that we all carry biases that are based on gender, and these biases become ingrained if we don't recognize them. When dealing with girls and boys in an educational setting, we need to look closely at how these biases may be affecting our attitudes or actions that may be leaving some of our children, especially our girls, behind.
Our language sends messages about our expectations based on gender. For instance, when we comment on how pretty girls look or how strong boys are, children notice these differences between girls and boys, which can develop into a narrow understanding of gender. So when dealing with boys and girls, watch your language and practice counteracting stereotypes.
Let's see what this looks like in action.
It's not jumping. I don't know how to fix it.
It's okay. It's hard. Not everybody likes solving problems. Instead, encourage her to solve problems, become self-reliant and confident.
It's not jumping. I don't know how to fix it.
Yeah. I mean, this is hard, but let's see if we can try another way to figure it out. Here is one example of what to avoid. Hey, my little engineer. See you're making some progress there. How can I help you?
I want to figure out how long my wings should be.
Are you having trouble with your design?
Yes.
You want to keep trying or switch to something else? You know, I really like your drawings. Your handwriting is really nice.
Thank you.
Such comments towards girls are commonly accepted in our society. We need to change this trend so we can present new opportunities to girls. Focus on character traits such as curiosity, creativity, and persistence. Even when we are very conscious of gender biases, it's very hard to provide feedback to boys and girls in the same way, and also pay the same amount of attention to them. Make sure when you are talking to a group, you provide the same attention to boys and girls. Now that we are aware of our own bias, let's try not to stereotype children based on their gender. Let's try to think of some questions we can ask girls that will help them break out of these social norms.